Biology of the anglerfish. The deep sea is the largest habitat on the planet, covering around 65% of the Earth's surface. However, most people know very little about the organisms that inhabit the deep sea. One of the most fascinating of these organisms is the anglerfish. With its unique appearance and interesting behaviors, anglerfish have been capturing the imaginations of people for many years. This video will explore in detail the biology of the anglerfish. We will discover the morphological details of the fish's interesting features. The way the anglerfish has adapted to its environment will be discussed in relation to its unique features. The anglerfish is a mainly deep-sea creature, so we will touch on how it has evolved to cope with the specific demands of this extreme environment. Finally, there will be a detailed discussion about the reproductive habits of the anglerfish. By the end of the video, it will become clear that the anglerfish is truly a fascinating and unique creature. Anatomy of the anglerfish. The anglerfish possesses a number of unusual characteristics that researchers believe have evolved in response to the dark, food-scarce environment in which the fish lives. Notably, it has an extendable stomach, hinged skull, and a luminescent lure in place of a dorsal fin. The anglerfish subsists on a predatory diet, and its bizarre physical and behavioral traits are geared towards helping it best survive in its habitat deep beneath the sea. The extendable stomach allows the anglerfish to consume prey up to twice its size. This is a very useful adaptation in an environment where food can be few and far between. The anglerfish can afford to eat less often, and when it does catch something, it can ingest a larger amount of food in a single meal. By doing so, the fish is able to take advantage of temporary high food availability and sustain itself through longer periods when no food is available. This reduces the need for the anglerfish to be constantly expending energy in the search for food. The stomach, which is capable of expanding to many times its initial size, folds itself into a pouch inside the abdominal cavity when not filled with food. From the outside, it looks like a bloated and distended sac, quite grotesque compared to a normal, empty stomach. The development and function of the anglerfish's hinged skull are less well understood, primarily because this type of anatomy is extremely rare and found in very few other vertebrates. The skull, which hinges at the top of the head and is essentially divided into two independently movable sections, frontal and preopercular, allows the anglerfish to greatly expand the volume of its mouth and maximize its ability to catch and swallow larger prey. At the same time, the fish is able to maintain the streamlined head and jaws necessary for hunting and moving through the water quickly. This provides the advantage of being able to both pursue prey and quickly launch an ambush with very little delay. The lure of the anglerfish is its most iconic feature and is actually a highly modified dorsal fin. This esca, as it is termed, contains bioluminescent bacteria capable of producing light. Three distinct species of symbiotic bacteria live within the lumen of the esca, and this environment has allowed scientists to make a detailed examination of bioluminescent symbiosis. Many have made the mistake of attributing the light produced by the esca to the fish when, in fact, the bioluminescence given off is a result of the bacteria. Studies have found that the anglerfish, or indeed the particular species bacteria, can emit different colors of light. Some release blue light, which can be detected in the deepest regions of the ocean, while others may produce green or red light, more visible in the shallower parts of its habitat. This suggests that the anglerfish has the ability to change the type of bacteria it harbors in the esca to better match the local environment. The anglerfish takes advantage of its luminescent lure to draw curiosity from other organisms and attract prey. This is particularly effective in the lightless world of the deep sea, where the glow given off by the esca can be seen by animals far off in the distance, and for which any abnormal light is likely to instill a natural instinct to investigate. By using a composite creature, the anglerfish is able to outwit creatures that would never have approached it under normal circumstances. The fish conserves energy and avoids giving chase or competing with other fish by allowing them to come to the light. Through color and light sight experiments, Scientists have now demonstrated that the animals of the deep sea are attracted to the esca of the anglerfish, hinting at how it has evolved into the remarkable hunting strategy we see today. Unique adaptations for survival. As if the anglerfish could not get any weirder, beyond its hunting method, mating oddities, and impressively terrifying appearance, this fascinating deep-sea creature has an array of unique adaptations that allow it not only to survive, but to thrive in one of the most extreme environments on Earth. First and foremost, it needs to be able to withstand the enormous pressure found at the depths. The majority of anglerfish live in what is known as the midnight zone of the ocean, depths of up to 4,000 meters, where sunlight cannot penetrate and temperatures are at or just above freezing. At these crushing depths, the pressure can be a staggering 10 to 30 times higher than at the surface. Most creatures would be slowly but surely crushed to death as they are carried from the surface to these depths, as their internal pressure would be far higher than the lower pressure of their new environment. However, the bodies of deep-sea fish are adapted to this, with both their flesh and blood containing compounds that make it easier to prevent the crippling of enzymes and proteins that could occur at high pressure and help to support cellular membranes. In the case of the anglerfish, the molecules within the flesh and blood act as a kind of natural ballast that adapt their densities to match the external pressure, so the fish can remain buoyant and move around freely despite the fact it may have been brought up from the midnight zone. Its gelatinous flesh is also extremely low in density, reducing the overall differences that could otherwise occur between the fish and the surrounding deep-sea environment. Every single adaptation of the anglerfish, from the bacteria in its stomach to its strange luring mechanism, allows it to eke out an existence where few other creatures can, and to shed light on wider research into genetics, taxonomy, and other fields. But in a habitat this harsh and unforgiving, evolution has refined the anglerfish, in all of its bizarre forms, into a creature perfectly suited for the deep sea. Reproduction and mating strategies. However, female anglerfish have a unique way of caring for their young and ensuring at least some of them survive into adulthood. Although it is difficult for scientists to study deep-sea anglerfish in the wild, over the years a few females have been found with groups of developing young. This has allowed biologists to learn more about the life cycle of these fascinating fish. Female anglerfish have adapted to the lack of males in the deep sea by evolving the ability to carry out internal fertilization and to store the sperm. So, whilst sexual reproduction is necessary to produce the next generation of baby anglerfish, a single mating pair is able to create many offspring over a long period of time. The male, once he has found a female, uses his extremely well-developed sense of smell to find a suitable area of her body where he can attach himself and begin to fuse to her skin. Over time, the male physically fuses to the female and all his organ systems, apart from the testes, degenerate, because the female provides everything they need. This is the ultimate sacrifice, as the male literally becomes a permanent part of the female for the rest of his short life. When scientists first started discovering these strange latched-on males, they believed that they were parasites, but it is now known to be a highly evolved mating strategy. On the other hand, the same cannot be said for the male hagfish, who dies after fertilizing the eggs of the female and the newborn young, then eat their way out of the mother. Anglerfish are great survivors and have very few predators due to the habitats they choose to inhabit. The relationship between the deep-sea anglerfish and the hagfish is a fascinating example of the variety of reproductive strategies that have evolved in the animal kingdom. This is such an interesting process to go through for a certain period of time of our lifetime. And given that the development takes a really long time, the female fish will live with a pair of fused males all the time till the end of her life, since the male has sacrificed for being the permanent nourishment supplier to the female. In conclusion, the anglerfish is truly a remarkable creature. It is astonishing to think that such a monstrous, hideous, and remarkable fish could actually exist. And the ultimate wonder is that scientists have still barely scratched the surface in understanding these animals. It is true that the deep sea is an incredibly harsh and unforgiving environment, And yet anglers have somehow not only managed to survive, but also to thrive there for untold eons of time. This startling fact is a testament to the efficacy of the various adaptations which anglers have evolved over countless centuries. The fascinating phenomena of sexual parasitism, as I have already discussed, presents an even clearer example of the amazing adaptations which little anglerfish have made in order to survive. The way in which tiny males have to effectively turn themselves into sperm machines, losing all their vital organs in the process, save for the testes, is one of the most extraordinary processes known in the animal kingdom. Yet in some miracle of nature, it seems to be a widely successful method of reproduction for the anglerfish. In fact, this strikingly unusual lifestyle has brought anglerfish iconic status, and it is arguably they who jump most readily to the minds of the general public upon mention of deep-sea creatures. My central thesis, that anglerfish biology seems almost too absurd to be true, has been consistently supported throughout this video, and I hope that I have managed to convey to you the levels of awe and wonder that the extraordinary nature of these animals inspires in me. Anglerfish are surely one of the most remarkable and mystifying demonstrations of the power of natural selection, that most fundamental of all biological processes in the entire world.